Hello, I'm Dr. Tina Ramachander. I'm into the practice of skin, hair and nail in its health, disease and aesthetics. So I have a special interest in lasers and dermatosurgery, and I practice at Dr. Tina Skin Solutionz in Sahakarnagar, Bangalore. Acne scar, while I would like to clarify, pre-treatment and post-treatment is a very important aspect of it. So acne scar therapy is a fairly invasive sort of a laser-based or surgical-based therapy. So I would like the skin of my patient to be well hydrated and sun-protected, along with certain applications which are customized according to the skin type of the patient. Now, acne can happen in sensitive dry skin and in oily skin. So it's not that one cream fits everybody. So I would like to prepare the patient's skin by telling them to use the right kind of products and also protect themselves from the sun, and then plan for the laser. Now, once your acne scar laser is done, which is usually a fractional carbon dioxide laser or erbium YAG laser, the patient is advised on how he can restart these applications and what are the healing creams. So in our practice, we usually give calming barrier repair creams as the first contact creams, and also certain creams to prevent secondary infection. The patient has already planned the fact that he cannot be working or going out in the sun for the next 5 days to 1 week. And there are certain simpler procedures for which they may require a weekend off, but everything has to be catered according to the depth of the laser used and what is the procedure plan. So very day that the procedure is done, the patient usually uses ice and calms the skin, uses these barrier repair creams as I have shared, along with an antibiotic cream. The next day he will wash just with water, and no soaps or face washes are done for at least a day. And that evening they restart their application, and which is a simple addition of face wash, moisturizer and sunscreen. So after a week, they restart on all their night applications, which are stronger, like a retinol, AHA, etc. So this is how we take care of the skin. So summarizing it, I would say the most important is protection from sun exposure, even warmth, heat exposure, no using makeup for the stipulated time, no scrubbing, and also making sure you're reintroducing your creams at the right time. If you overdo it, it always leads to repercussions. So always be clear on how you have to take care pre and post the procedure. Both are equally important.